Hi, today we have Dacia Logan 1.5 TDI DCI engine. I'm going to show you how to change the front right bearing. First we are going to raise the vehicle, remove the front wheel, and we are going to open also the center bolt here. Now we have removed the wheel, open the center bolt, and now we have to open the lower ball joint, also the ball joint that goes to the steering rack, and from the shock absorber the two bolts. We are opening the two bolts here of the shock absorber with 19 mm wrench. This ball joint is with 17 mm and the lower ball joint is with 17 mm and there are two bolts that hold the brake caliper with 19 mm wrench. They are here and over here. Now we can remove the top two bolts and then we can remove the whole unit. We have removed almost everything. Now we just have to remove from the lower ball joint. We have removed the whole unit. You can hear the winding that is making the bearing. Now we have to remove the disc. You can see these ones are in very bad condition, but they will be changed later. We are going to remove the disc by opening this bolt here. We are using Torx key 40, and now we are going to remove the disc with a little hammering. The disc has been removed. Now we have to remove this center section on the hydraulic press we are going to use and push it here to remove it, to remove the hub. We have removed the hub and now we have to remove the bearing. First we are going to remove this security pin here. We are going to use pliers. We remove the pin. And now we can remove the bearing from the housing. Now we have removed the bearing from the housing. This is the old bearing. Now we are going to take a new one. Here we have new bearing. And now we are going to install it. We are going to grease a little the inside here so the bearing can go in easily. We are pushing the new bearing with the old bearing inside. That's why we are not going to damage the new bearing. We can see now the bearing is all the way in, and now we can install the security pin here. We have installed the security pin. We are leaving this part here to the downside, so if there is any water collecting here, it can go it can not to stay here in the bearing. Now we have to remove from the hub. We have to pull out this that has left from the old bearing. We have removed the part that was from the old bearing. Now we can clean it, grease it, and we can install the hub into the new bearing. We have cleaned the hub. Now we can install into the bearing. Now we are pushing the hub inside the bearing. We have inserted the hub into the bearing. there is no winding now, and now we can mount it on the vehicle. Now I have to mention, don't install the bearing with the hammer, because the bearing is going to destroy it. If you don't have hydraulic press, just remove the whole unit like this, take it to the specialist, it will remove and install the bearing, and then you can install yourself on the vehicle. First we are going to install on the lower ball joint together with the drive shaft. We have put the drive shaft inside into the hub, and we have installed the lower ball joint. We can install the bolt now, and then we can mount it onto the shock absorber and put the two bolts. Now we can install the ball joints from the steering rack. And we can tighten all the bolts now. These ones are with 19mm wrench, 17mm, 17mm. Then we can install the disc. We have put the center bolt, we have tightened it very well. We have installed the disc, tightened with the bolt. Now we can install the brake caliper mounting. And now we can install the wheel. We can lower the car, and now we are finished.